are you? I hope you guys are having a wonderful day today. So today, I got this idea from Kelly Gooch here on YouTube, but I did it a little bit differently. I wanted to go through and rank all of my highlighters from best to worst. However, I have a lot of highlighters. I have a ton, and I know that about myself. Highlighters are one of my weaknesses when it comes to makeup. I own like a billion for no reason, but I love them all. They're all my children. So I wanted to rank everything from best to worst, but I knew that if I ranked my entire collection, it would be a struggle. So I decided to break it up into three core categories, and that is my most highlighters that I have, which would be more golden toned highlighters, more pinky toned highlighters, and more just like miscellaneous, whatever's left over. Most of them I'm assuming are going to be more white toned highlighters, and that is the highlighters that I'm going to be showing you guys. I'm not going to be including highlighter palettes, because if I do make this a series, I'm going to do a face palettes one where I rank all my face palettes. So I think it's better to just stick to the singles today, my single highlighters. And I also don't know if I'm going to include too many of my like cream or gel highlighters, just because I don't use those too much. I'll decide later, but I'm basically just going to be showing you guys best to worst, my worst highlighters, my best highlighters. They're all things that I love, so this is going to be kind of tricky, but I think this will be a really interesting thing to kind of show you guys why I love what I love the most and why I don't love what I love the most, if that makes sense. I hope you guys like this video. Without further ado, let's jump into my hands, swatching things, and just getting it done. Okay, so these are all of my gold highlighters. This is pretty much the gist. Most of my highlighters are either pinky or goldy, as I explained in the intro, and these ones are the more golds. Some of them have a slight tinge of pink to them, but I know that when they show up on the cheek, they show up a lot more gold. So now we have to rank, and that's gonna be hard because as you can tell, gold and pink highlighters like are my favorite. So this is gonna be tricky to have to rank my gold ones. I think first and foremost, this Marc Jacobs one. I have the other Marc Jacobs one, the New Runway collection, that's more of a white tone, and I mix this with the whiter one. I mix the two together, and it is beautiful. It's so pretty mixing the two of them together. However, on its own, it is a little too dark for me. So I think this is gonna go more towards the end, not because it's a bad formula, but because the coloring is kind of weird. I am gonna put my Anastasia one also towards the end. This is my loose highlighter in So Hollywood. I don't really like this, which is crazy because I thought I was gonna love it. I wish she would just come out with pressed powders in So Hollywood so I could like get that again. Packaging is really pretty though. It's not bad, but when you compare it to this, which is the Juvia's Place highlighter. This Juvia's Place highlighter is one of my favorite. It's like one of the only loose highlighters I love. I think because these two are so similar, when you compare them together, this one is more expensive and not as glowy or good. And this one is incredibly pigmented, glowy, and beautiful. So I'm gonna put this one more towards the end and put this one more towards the beginning, but it's not gonna be like the best. Let's talk MAC. So this is the MAC Whisper of Guilt, which is a little bit of a goldy highlighter you can see. And then I also have MAC Double Gleam, which this is more of a like white gold. I don't know if you can see that, but it's still got gold to it. Both of these are beautiful. I think they're gonna go one after the other. I like Double Gleam a little bit more than Whisper of Guilt, just because it's a really unique and interesting formula and color. These are probably more mid-range though of my collection, if I'm being honest. I don't love these, but I don't hate them either. So I think I'm gonna put them more in the middle. And then this Pure one is actually beautiful. This is a really nice everyday glow. This is their Afterglow highlighter. This is really beautiful. I can't really complain at all. Probably should be swatching these for you guys. But you can see it's both of these, but this is a more pigmented, this is a more spread out. Really beautiful glow to it. So I think I am gonna put this more towards the front. I haven't decided if it beats MAC yet. Let's keep going. This Almay one is the worst. I talked about this in my worst products so far of 2019 video. This is awful. I am gonna declutter this during my next declutter, but I'm keeping it now because I might do a video using this. But this is the end. This is like absolutely the worst one. My Ofra highlighter is gonna go very much towards the front. This is one of my favorite highlighters in general of all time, and it's probably one of my most used highlighters. That's gonna go towards the front, as is my Anastasia Amreezy. When I first got this, I just kind of felt like I didn't really understand the hype because it was like just a gold highlighter, but it's actually the more I use it, the more I love it. So I'm gonna put this kind of tied with that right now because these two kind of knew, oh, you can't really see them, kind of knew that Ofra and Amreezy were gonna be similar. This Lancome one, I love this color. This is in the shade 05 Sparkling Peach? I don't know. And this is a really, really beautiful one as well. I think this would definitely beat out MAC and Pure. My Jouer Citrine would probably beat out... I think this does not get beat out by MAC. I think MAC wins on that one. Can you guys still see these? I'm trying to keep everything in frame. This, I think, would beat out my MAC. I love Jouer Citrine. It's beautiful. This NARS one, I don't love that much. This is in Fort de France. It's an okay highlighter, and it's, I mean, it's pretty. It's very, like, kind of subtle compared to the other ones, which is not necessarily bad. However, with subtle highlighters, I prefer things like the Pure, or I prefer something like my Natasha Denona Super Glow, which will be in the next round. So this one is definitely gonna go like in here. It's not bad, but it's not like the most amazing thing you've ever had in your life. All right, we're getting down to it. This is over here. Prosecco Pop from Becca. Really nice, but I don't use this very often. This doesn't get used a ton. Not because it's bad, though, because I love the Becca formula, but I prefer Moonstone to this. This is also a pretty true gold. Some of these are like white golds. This is like a true golds. I think this probably goes after MAC. And then my Pixie. This is a Pixie by Aspen Overt. I got this at Marshall's a few weeks ago. You can kind of see this is, I mean... so beautiful. And I think this would probably go in the same realm as like my Jouer highlighter, I think. And then this is the Morphe one in Extra. This is again more of kind of a white gold. This one definitely pales in comparison to others. So I think this would be in par with my NARS formula. So let's make some decisions because we have some ties right now. So this is the worst for sure, this All May one. And then I think it would go Marc Jacobs, not because of the formula. And then I'm definitely gonna go with the Anastasia loose pigmented one as third worst. I think the Morphe one is worse than the NARS one. Well, the problem is I love all of my highlighters. So even though some of them are technically the worst, I love all of these except this one. So it's kind of hard because it's like, well, it's the worst, but it's the worst of the best things ever. So this one would definitely be next. Then the NARS, then the Prosecco Pop, then Pure. Okay, God, this is so hard. Okay, so Double Gleam, I definitely think is gonna go before Whisper of Guilt. Yeah, so it would go Whisper of Guilt, Double Gleam. Let's start down here now. Jouer would, Lancome would probably be next. No, the Pixie one would probably be next. Then Jouer. I do love this Lancome one, so I think the Lancome one will be next. Then my Juvia's Play. Okay, this is so hard. And then I think I have to go Ofra for best. This Ofra highlighter is just so good. It's like actually phenomenal. This is such a beautiful, good highlighter. So how it stands right now would be Ofra Rodeo Drive is the best. Anastasia Imrizzi, second. Lancome, which is surprising, but Sparkling Pash is a beautiful shade, would be third. Juvia's Place Loose would be fourth. Jouer Citrine. Pixie Time Aspen Ovard. So this is my top five right here. Top five of my gold highlighters. So they win the golds, all of them. These are all amazing, beautiful golds and highlighters. And all of these are also very good. These are like the best. Like, these are the ones I enjoy using the most for a more goldeny highlighter. So as you can see, I love pink highlighters. So these are all of my pink friends that I just love and are amazing. And now I have to rate them. So I know right off the bat, Natasha Denona Super Glow is going to be near the top. This actually broke and I repressed it. Poorly, but I did. So I am going to put this near the front because I know that she's going to be a top contender. This Smashbox Vlada one, I think, is going to be more of a mid-tier. I like this because, first of all, the packaging is really pretty, but also I love the formula of this. It's a very gilded glow, but I wouldn't necessarily call it, like, my favorite thing on the planet, but it definitely does not warrant, like, the ending. So let's put that more mid-tier. This will definitely go near the end. This is the Kaja Mochi Glow. Talked about before in a video how much I dislike this one, but again, I'm keeping it for a different video. So this is gonna go near the end. She's not on good terms with me right now. This Inglot Sparkler is beautiful, but again, I think it's gonna go more towards the end, not because it's bad, just because it's kind of difficult to find occasions to wear this because it's, I'll show you, it's so incredibly sparkly and kind of like a peachy tone. So it's a little bit more of a unique highlight. For that reason, because it's not as wearable, I do think it would go more towards the end, not because it's bad. This Artist Couture highlighter in Purple Dream, it does have a pinky shift to it, I'll show you. This is not my favorite thing at all. I don't like this very much. It's very, very pink. It's very micro glittery. I did get this in BoxyCharm, and I think if I could have picked the Artist Couture highlighter that I wanted, I would have picked a more goldy shade, and I would have liked it better. As it stands, I don't particularly like this shade, so that is going to go down there as well. This Hard Candy one is cute, but it's not like blow your mind. It's just kind of cute. Just kind of there, you know? I'm going to put this towards the end too. This is beautiful. This is the JCAT Beauty You Glow Girl, and this is in the shade 103 Pink Goddess. This is beautiful. Hello. Like, she's stunning. She's beautiful. I think this actually would be kind of, not an exact dupe, because this is obviously more of a bright pink, but I think if you want something that has the same sparkle effect as this Fenty Beauty one, this would be a good one for you, like a similar formula. However, I do think this is really good, so this is going to be more mid-tier as well. My two Fenty, this one is going to be more towards the end, but it's not because I don't love it. It's just because, again, wearability. This is not something I reach for super often because it's such a unique shade. However, I freaking love this. It's really, really quite beautiful, and I really, really enjoy it. So it's gonna be in the higher, probably mid-level. Along with this one, this is the duo in Girl Next Door and Chic Freak. And this duo is definitely gonna go probably before this. I'm gonna split the two Fenty up because this one I love. Then we have the Ciate London in Starburst. This one, again, it's beautiful, but it's definitely not the most amazing thing you've ever tried in your entire life. So I think I'm gonna put this more with like the Hard Candy. This is easier, actually. I don't know why. Ofra's Pillow Talk, beautiful. Probably a little bit more mid-tier though, because even though it's so pretty, it's definitely one I don't reach for as much because it's so blinding. So with this one, because it is so blinding, again, this is kind of like a pow moment. So I think I am gonna put this more towards here. I can't believe this one's getting placed up so high. Whisper of Soft and Gentle is also really beautiful. This is probably gonna be in one of the top. This is just a beautiful, it's this one right here, just a beautiful pinky glow that I love. I'm gonna put the top five down here, I think. And this one is probably gonna end up being more in like the mid-range, even though this is beautiful. This is from the new MAC collection, the Electric Feels. This is called Serenity Seeker. And this is very, very pretty. It's got a lot of sparkle to it, you can see. It's got a lot of gold shift with like the pinky in it. I do enjoy this, but I think it is more of a mid-tier one. We'll put that here. This Wet n Wild powder is beautiful. I can't even lie. This is probably going to be towards the top as well because this has always been one of my favorite highlighters and it is very inexpensive, which I love. This MAC highlighter in Bleeming Blush. This is actually probably going to be more towards the end and not because it's terrible. Just out of my MAC highlighters, this one is my least favorite. It's not the best performing out of all of them. This actually was my first one that I ever got, my first Extra Dimension Skin Finish. So I think I am gonna put this like right in here. And then my Pixie by Petra is in the top three. This is beautiful. One of the best highlighting things I've ever bought. Like this, I bought this recently and it's already very used. This is beautiful. And then my Morphe Spark highlighter is also very used. I love this highlighter. I'm trying to decide though if this would go in the top five, and I actually think it would. I think this would probably be my top five. And then I'm debating, I think this should go up a little bit. My Ofra. Interesting that the JCAT one is so high up because I never really thought about this highlighter as being one of my favorites, but when I compare it to my other pink ones, this is a really beautiful highlighter. So my top five would definitely be the Natasha Denona Super Glow in the shade O2 light medium. This is just I would rebuy this in a heartbeat. This is a beautiful, beautiful formula. MAC Soft and Gentle, which I do think is kind of a cult classic for a reason. This is a beautiful pinky highlighter. This Pixi by Petra one almost might, these are kind of tied in my mind, truly, because this Pixi by Petra one is beautiful. Morphe's Spark. This is Spark, right? Yeah, Morphe's Spark has always been one of my like tried and true favorites. Ever since I bought it, I've just loved this one. And then, of course, my Wet n Wild highlighting powder. This is in Precious Petals, and this is just a beautiful, natural glow. I think if you want a semi-dupe for the Natasha Denona Super Glow, this would be a good dupe formula-wise. I don't know color-wise, because color-wise, they're definitely very different. They're kind of similar, but formula wise they're very similar, except not. I don't know how to explain it. Like, if you don't want to spend the money on this one because this is pretty expensive, I think you would be satisfied with this one, happy with that one. And then we have, you know, the JCat, the Fenty, the Duos, Pillow Talk, this new one from MAC, the Vlada collection, the Whatabrat. We have the peach one from here, and then all of these ones down here kind of come in. My least five would be the Kaja Mochi Glow, Artist Couture one, Inglot Sparkler, this Hard Candy one, and this Ciate one. But from the Inglot Sparkler and up, like, I love them. These are the only two that I'm not, like, obsessed with as far as my highlighter collection goes. This is hard because I really do love all of these. So it's hard because I think this is a good highlight and so is this one. So it's hard for me to be like, oh, well, they're in last place. But I can't think of anyone's other than this that wouldn't be in this spot. You know what I mean? This is tough. Okay, let's do the rest of the highlighters, kind of miscellaneous, and then we will be done. Okay, so these are the remaining ones that are kind of like the miscellaneous colors. Most of these are either a white or just like a more neutral shade. So let's get started. So this one is actually from a subscriber. A subscriber from Japan sent this to me. So this is actually near the top. Simply, number one, it is beautiful. Like, look at that glow. So, so, so beautiful. So this one is near the top. And also, since the subscriber gave it to me, it's like really sentimental. And the fact that it's from Japan, I find to be really cool. So this one is near the top. This is from Laura Geller, and this is in the shade Diamond Dust. My mom is always doing the View Your Deal from The View. She loves that show, and they had a bunch of Laura Geller stuff on sale, and she picked this one up for me. I actually think this is a super cool highlighter. I love the formula on this. I think the shift is beautiful, how it goes from a white to a sort of deep purple. I think that is super unique and cool. So this is another one that's gonna go towards the top. This is a Kevin Aucoin, the Neo Highlighter in Sahara. I picked this up. I remember Hannah Louise Poston talking about this a long time ago in a video, and I saw it at TJ Maxx, and it was really affordable. It was like super, super discounted. So I kind of wanted to give it a go. It does have a more neutral finish to it. Like, it's not the most blinding thing, but I find on natural days, this is stunning for natural days. Oh, I love all of these ones. This is gonna be tough. But this one I think goes ahead right now. As far as this goes, this is the Marc Jacobs, the Runway one I was talking about that I mixed with the gold. This mixed with the gold, beautiful. This on its own, also beautiful. It's a really pretty, look how like, are you kidding? It's a really pretty like glazed kind of formula that's very pigmented. It kind of reminds me of Glazed Donut, except Glazed Donut has a little bit more of a pearly sheen, while this is a little bit more of a matte sheen, if that makes sense. These two go neck and neck in my mind, honestly. I think the Laura Geller one gets moved down only because this isn't as wearable, but this is so freaking cool. Like, this is such a cool highlighter. This is Laura Mercier's Indiscretion. This is more of a bronze shade, like a true bronze, and it's really, really quite beautiful. I got sent this from Laura Mercier, and it was actually a really surreal moment because I'd wanted this for a really long time, and then I got picked to get sent it, and I freaked out because I just couldn't believe that, like, I just can't believe that. But this is probably gonna go more up here. And then I think my Juvia's Place highlighter wins this round. This is a beautiful kind of white metallic wet. It's just so wet on the skin. I'm gonna swatch it everywhere. I can't get over how wet looking it looks on your face. So I think this would be first. I think this would probably be second. This is probably towards the end. This, and then this. So this is what it would be. Juvia's Place, Laura Mercier, this one from Japan, Marc Jacobs, Ofra The Laura Geller one, and then Kevin Aucoin. Not because the Kevin Aucoin or the Laura Geller are bad. This one is not as wearable because it's the purple. And this one is just more neutral than my other highlighters. So if we're talking best highlighter, this would be more towards the end. But yeah, I think that's everything. I think that's all of my highlighters. Nutty. Okay, thank you. All right, friends. So that was all of my highlighters ranked. I hope you guys liked this video. If you want me to rank other parts of my collection, like my bronzers, my blushes, my eyeshadow palettes, which would be so difficult, let me know down below. I love doing this, actually. It's kind of fun to introspect on why I like the things I like and for what reasons, and I have so many swatches covering my arm. But yeah, I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, please like and subscribe, or just like, or just subscribe, or do neither. Honestly, just so happy you're watching me. Thank you so much for being here. My merch, my social media, and everything I'm wearing on my face will be linked down below. And yeah, I love you guys so, so much, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!